Hello, everyone. Welcome to Ozark Radio, brought to you by the Inside Straight and Thanatopsis Club. I'm Dan Krotz, filling in for Richard Pillay, who is traveling on family business. Let me give a quick shout-out to Jane Elderwind, Jennifer Hudspeth, and Lynn Welford, and all of the volunteers of the Carroll and Madison County Library Foundation for a very successful Books in Bloom Festival last week at the Crescent Hotel. It was a marvelous event, as we expected, and it came off without a hitch, including the weather. Anyways, thank you, Jane, Jennifer, Lynn, and all of the volunteers at the Carroll and Madison County Library Foundation for a really wonderful event. Pretty good show today. Sharon Laborde has been in Birmingham, Alabama for a bit and shares the details of her visit home with us. I always find Sharon's stories to be the highlight of every program, and I feel so fortunate that she has agreed to share her time and talent with us when she could obviously be on big time public radio instead. So Sharon, thanks for hanging out with poor folk like me and Richard. We appreciate you. Jim Young, another regular contributor and someone we love very much, shares his always inspiring thoughts on Be Here Now, and he also tells some very funny church sign sayings that he's run across over the years. Jim is followed by an update from Peggy Duncan about the American Legion Axillary Memorial Day celebration and parade. Peggy gives us a celebration schedule and how and when we should all convene for the band concert and the Memorial Day speeches. Suzy Q is back with the roots and reach of music and tells us about a couple of really wonderful blues legends. Suzy is followed by Jon Toombs, who finishes his three-part lecture on organic pest control. We've gotten a lot of good feedback from listeners about Jon, and we hope to have him back on the air with us soon. We also visited the Village Writing School, which is located in Eureka Springs. That was a couple of weeks ago, and while we were there, we recorded some of their writers, who we will share with you over the summer. This week, we feature June Verity and Ken Lockhart. It was also my pleasure to attend open mic night at Brews in Eureka Springs on a recent Wednesday evening, where I caught up with Kate Lucariello. Kate read two poems that I found to be really quite wonderful, and she's going to read them for us now.
My name is Kate Lucariello, and I'm going to read two poems. The first is called Missouri Swamp, and I don't know how many of you may not know that there is a swamp in Missouri about an hour north of here, and it has tupelo trees growing in it, and it's a very unusual geological or botanical thing to have a swamp in Missouri. Missouri Swamp. Tupelo treetops sway in the dome of sky, afternoon sunlight, limbs their branch tips gold as they dance. The swamp is still, but for some small ripples answering the dance above them, while stately, stationary, spread trunks stand planted firm in the slough like elephants' feet, and the pond around them is skimmed with a thin shim of winter ice. The wind sighs through, and birds go still to hear its solo, then call in soft trills and curt chirps as it passes. Alone out here in the miles from anything, the seasons pass. The earth revolves, and the sun with his retinue lines up with his galactic home. The swamp aligns as well, the tupelos dreaming, silently humming, with the turning of the age. Thank you. Thank you. The second poem is titled Solar Eclipse, October 2014, and it's written in honor of Marie Turnock. I don't know how many of you remember her, but she was quite a community activist and central person for metaphysical and healers. She had the Arkansas Healers website. She passed away last fall. Solar Eclipse, October 2014. Why is it light? My friend is gone. The dark should fail the day, yet pale light limns the lake and distant clouds and hills, as if her brilliance cannot be eclipsed, for she has passed through shadow, schooling us to follow, yet remain behind. In deepening night, in dreams, she strides away. Where are you going? Why do you leave? I have a task that must be done. I will be back. No crying. We are one. Fish leap. Nine geese skate the lake. A sip of light rests in a cup of hills and spills into the water. Let go the fear, the care, the wear, the sore, the hurt, and all that stills your light. Shine, dear soul, shine, and face approaching night. The dark will have no place, no strength to smother love. Instead, it will transform to comfort, soothe, and warm until its time is come. Thank you.
Kate, thanks so much for sharing your work with us. We really, really liked it and hope we can talk you into being on the program again in the future. Next up is an interview with life coach Jessie Rex, who is a professional life coach and helps people take on some of the big challenges that change presents. We like to feature small businesses on Ozark Radio, and Jessie Rex operates a fascinating one. Here's our interview with Jessie Rex. Jessie Rex, welcome to the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here.
You have got me stumped. I'm not exactly sure what life coaching means. Can you fill me in?
I sure can. A life coach is someone that people will go to when they are either needing to set a goal, maybe feel a little stuck and what they want to do, or they know what they want to do and they're just having problems getting there. And so we sit down together and we see what they want, what is their goal, and then we make a plan, mm-hmm. and I hold them accountable to that.
Ah, okay. What are some of these goals that people are trying to achieve?
It can range anywhere. It's common that people will come needing some help with weight loss, and generally it's just kind of getting them on a plan, you know, what's working for them and what's not. We can set goals for careers, people who want to change jobs, or a lot just don't even have a clue where they want to go, you know, what they're really wanting. And then there's people who also want help with social media, mm-hmm. to setting goals there, you know, what to do for their business, what works best.
Uh-huh. Okay. Sitting across from you is an old fat man who is generally aimless. What could you do for me?
Well, we'd probably start off just, of course, getting to know you a little bit and seeing just in general, what are your interests? What do you enjoy doing? You know, mm-hmm. if you could pick anything you could do, we'd want to know that and kind of go from there.
Uh-huh. Okay. And Jessie, how is it that you got into this line of work?
Well, it was pretty interesting. Several years back, I've always enjoyed writing since I was very young, and I decided to get serious. So I started a book, and it was going to be a novel about some women and their relationships. I've always been kind of fascinated with you know, friends and friendships and relationships and how they work. So I just kept digging for information, doing some research on relationships. And it just kept popping up here and there, a life coach or a article written by a life coach. Uh-huh. And I just kept seeing that. And so, I thought I'm going to look into that. And so I looked to see what is a life coach? What do they do? And it really sparked my interest. So I, you know, not knowing what career I was going to, you know, start doing after my divorce, I looked into it and I thought, I'm going to try it. So I did this really inexpensive online course, flew through it. I loved every moment of it. And so then I did some serious research into a good program, you know, what, as far as cost and what they offered, and went on to be a master life coach.
All right.
Got a certificate.
So you are a CMLC, which means that you're a certified master life course.
Coach, yes.
Coach.
Yes.
Okay. A certified master life coach. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, what did the training involve?
A lot of reading. I got my training from the American Neurolinguistics Programming, and their general programming has to do with the relationship between behavior patterns and thought patterns. And so I didn't do the neural training, but I did the master life coach training, which is similar in, you know, behavior and how people act and react. And then just did a lot of that study, a lot of testing, a lot of quizzing. I had to write some papers of how I would deal with certain situations.
Yeah,
and just to help people reach their goals.
Okay.
And you know, I studied why they don't. And it was just very interesting. I just loved it.
Uh-huh. All right. The process for you was you had set a goal or kind of a dream for yourself of being a writer.
Mm-hmm.
And you were looking for ways of making that happen, and you kind of stumbled on life coaching as a way. Is that right?
That is right. And I did continue my writing, and as it happens, you know, I'm still working on writing, but I've kind of switched over from doing that novel, and now I'm working on a self-help book to go with my coaching.
Okay. Very good. What's the schedule for your self-help book?
Good question. I my goal is to get the first final draft done this year. Uh-huh. So, and it's very beneficial, of course, here that I work at the Village Writing School. And I love, it's just like the best of both worlds for me, because part of life coaching, what draws me is I love to hear people's stories.
Uh-huh.
You know, where are they, you know, where do they come from is good, but I want to know, you know, how do you feel today and where do you want to go? I want to help you get to where you go. And of course, the people who come through these doors all have amazing stories.
Uh-huh.
So I enjoy helping them as well. And so I'm also attending a little circle here to work on my own writing.
Ah, very good.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So if a person came in and said that they had a goal of losing some weight, what would they expect?
Well, we'd expect a lot of questions. I kind of want to know what their daily life is like. You know, what's your lifestyle like?
Mm-hmm.
You know, obviously, weight loss is going to be completely different for everyone. It works, what works and what does not. So I'd ask them to do a little homework. You know, if when someone's serious, they're willing to do whatever, you know, it takes. And so we do a little homework of what their life is like on a daily basis. And we'd start with really small changes. You know, 1 week we're going to do just one slight thing different. And although it seems slow and we're always anxious, you know, we can be very impatient about wanting results right away. But when we start real slow and you accomplish that one step, you're able to move on forward. And it's amazing how people look back and, you know, their life has changed.
Uh-huh. Okay. Not typically, but sometimes writers in particular have trouble with procrastination. Is that something that you could help people with?
Well, sure. And that's very common, you know, and even I have to watch myself. One of the big keys is setting goals and not just saying you're going to do it, but you know, you need to write it down and have a visual, write it on the calendar. And, you know, if you come to me for help, you know, I'm going to check on you and I'm going to see where you're at and hold you accountable. You know, that's part of what I do.
Okay.
And you know, that helps knowing that you've got to be accountable to someone and you've set a goal. It keeps you motivated.
Okay, cool. Jessie Rex, tell me who the ideal client is. Who succeeds with a life coach?
You know, it's those who have finally set their mind that they want to make a change. You know, even a change for the better can be very difficult. So it's those who are very open to say, you know, I'm going to try and, you know, what we work together to think that's going to work for me.
Uh-huh.
Willing to try, knowing that it may not work, but we're just going to tweak it a little bit, you know. Uh-huh. A lot of our, I guess, our stops or our, you know, that doesn't work has to do with our thinking. So we really work on the thought process.
So you really need the people really need to change the way they think about things.
Sure. We so often put limits on what we think we can do or accomplish.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I know perfectionism was sometimes a barrier that I had to deal with, and it kept me from engaging some opportunity or task. Is that common?
Sure, yes, absolutely.
And sometimes people have unrealistic dreams. Is that does that happen? Someone thinks that they don't want to really be a writer, they want to be a best-selling millionaire writer. Is that
well, that's not as common, you know. Generally, I just see clients who they really don't set their goal high enough because, you know, they're afraid they can't reach it. You know, fear is a big factor in not getting our goals reached. But I guess I really haven't, you know, run across someone yet whose goal was way out there. You know, I'd help rein them down a little bit. Let's start with small goals till we get there. It's possible, of course.
Sure.
It's possible.
Sure. All right. Before we go, Jessie, I have the natural curiosity about how it is that you got to Eureka Springs, Arkansas. How did you come to live here?
Oh, well, actually, I've been in the Ozarks for 22 years.
Wow.
I married very young, and my young husband and I had a 4-week-old baby when I was 21, and we took off from Iowa and came here not knowing a soul, and we lived just over the state line in the Eagle Rock area. And I started building homes, and we did that for many, many years. And so I've been coming to Eureka, obviously, on and off since then. But I've only been living here about 9 months. So I just came here, and I love being in Eureka. Uh-huh. It's so nice to be closer. And there were so many things I didn't even realize were here to do. Uh-huh. So it's just a pleasure living here.
All right.
And the people are great.
Tell our listeners how they can get a hold of you.
Sure. I have a website. It is jessierex.com.
Okay.
And you can contact me there. And if you are in town and going by, you can probably find me at the Village Writing School. You just come on in and see me.
All right. So just south of downtown on Highway 23.
Yes, right? That is correct. Yes.
All right. Very good. Well, Jessie Rex, Certified Master Life Coach, thanks for being with us today on the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour.
Thank you very much.